From San Francisco, California, this is the Rock and Roll Geek Show.
This is the story of my rock and roll butler.
Welcome to the Rock and Roll Geek Show. My name is Michael Butler. Thanks a lot for joining me. I really appreciate it. Today is Tuesday, August 20th, 2019. It's 4:44 p.m. when I'm recording. This is day 20 of the Dog Days of Podcasting, where I attempt to do a show a day for the entire month of August, along with, I don't know how many other people, but some other people are doing it. DogDaysOfPodcasting.com. Back to work today. All I thought about all day was, one, missing my place in the mountains, missing being up there. Two, I was listening to podcasts today and also listened to Eddie Trunk on Sirius. And anyway, that's not the, I had to listen to him with wired earbuds. I know it's kind of hipster to have the Apple earbuds, but I love those things. And when I was up there painting the outside of the place, or staining the outside of the place up in the mountains, I left them in my pants pocket and put them in the washing machine. And consequently, my earbuds died. Apple AirPods. $150. Right down the drain. So I had to use wired. And it's tough when you're painting 25 feet up in a ladder. It was just tough, but yeah, I know. That's a third world or first world problem. I know. So, back to work today. Good, because I'm broke. Hint, hint. Donations. Thank you. Horrible, putrid, stench-filled, et cetera, et cetera. Okay. Well, I got an audio comment from, I think this is from Chris Capel, the Rock and Roll copywriter.
Michael Butler, this is Chris Capel, the Rock and Roll copywriter from Connecticut, giving a show review for not one, but two nights of the Rolling Stones at MetLife Stadium in New Jersey, the place...
Hold on. My good friend Chiaki had VIP passes on Sunday night. I have not talked to Chiaki yet how this show was, but I'm going to assume it was fantastic.
The New York Jets and the New York Giants play a fairly new stadium. But first, pleasure before business.
Yes.
How you doing?
I'm super great. Could not be better. Thank you for asking, Chris Capel.
All right. Rock on.
Yeah.
All right. So, this show was, or these shows are actually originally scheduled for June, but then...
Oh, was that Mick Jagger's heart attack?
Mick Jagger had a operation on his heart, so they were postponed until August 1st and August 5th. All right, so the first show was August 1st.
He went to two shows? Chris Capel must be loaded.
I had two tickets for that.
He sends me pictures all the time. Like, every weekend, he's at another concert. Good for you, Chris Capel. He's a rock fan. That is for damn sure.
By the way, in case you didn't know, and how would you know, because I didn't tell you this, I have been divorced for a while.
Oh, really? I did not know that. Huh. I was going to ask if he went with his wife. No wonder he goes to concerts every weekend. Oh, I'm sorry to hear that, Chris Capel. First time I ever met Chris Capel, I went, he met me in North Beach, and he was there with his wife and kids. Sorry to hear that, Chris Capel. I hope you're doing okay.
I went to the show on the 1st.
Wait a minute, why did he say that? Let me rewind that. That's something that I didn't really need. He didn't really need to tell me, but I appreciate you being honest, Chris Capel.
It was August 1st. I had two tickets for that. Oh, by the way, in case you didn't know, and how would you know, because I didn't tell you this, I have been divorced for a while, so...
Did you bring a guy or a girl or your ex-wife or one of your kids? Or did you just eat one of the tickets?
I went to the show on the 1st, and I actually had a blind date.
Oh.
A woman I met on an online dating site.
Hey, man, that's a good first impression, an online dating site. Which one was it? Well, a little pro tip, because Lance, our old singer in American Heartbreak, is an OK Cupid fanatic, and He's gotten quite lucky on OKCupid, from what I've heard. As a matter of fact, he found his new, the mother of his baby on OKCupid.
You know, lived near me, but she didn't know who I was, so she said she'd meet me at the stadium, so she did.
Blind date. Woo! That's ballsy, Chris Capel.
And she got there, and she looked like her picture, and she was awesome, and I really like her, but that's neither.
Uh-oh. Big butt. Not literally big butt, but a butt. You said butt.
I'll get into the set list, and then we'll talk a little about the show. Set list is as follows, and as you will note, it's a pretty much of a greatest hit show.
I did not know that.
Especially the first night. Here we go.
Oh, they changed up sets. Oh, that's a good for the Stones, changing the setup. Let me back it up just a little bit.
Then there was a section where you voted for a song, which I didn't.
Wait a minute. I'm busting. I fucked up.
Here we go. Street Fighting Man.
Ah.
Let's spend the night together.
Wait a minute. The Street Fighting Man. What was the second song? Back it up. I apologize for interrupting.
Pretty much of a greatest hit show. Especially the first night.
I'm going to stop interrupting.
Here we go. Street Fighting Man, let's spend the night together.
Let's spend the night together now. Blah, 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 blah. Good 1-2 punch.
Tumbling Dice.
Oh, good one. Call me to tumble and die. Butler's played that occasionally.
Then there was a section where you voted for a song.
We're going to play. We took a vote. How y'all doing, MetLife Stadium? We took a vote, and this is what you voted for.
Didn't vote on because I didn't know about it, and they took She's a Rainbow.
Ooh, she's a rainbow.
Obscurity from the 60s. You can't always get what you want.
I saw her today, the reception.
Then they move out.
Actually, I like that tune.
Down the ego ramp, there's a second little stage out
there. We're
going
to walk down the ramp for you.
Acoustic set.
A little acoustic.
Sweet Virginia and Dead Flowers.
Sweet Virginia. Wait a minute. Sweet Virginia and what?
Down the ego ramp, there's a second little stage out there for a couple song acoustic set. Sweet Virginia and Dead Flowers.
Butler's played Dead Flowers too occasionally. And I won't be dead flowers on your grave. I do the high harmony on that. Take me down, little sister. Take me down. Something like that. I don't remember the words. But Butler's play it, so I mumble it.
Uh-oh. And then they get this.
Somebody's calling me.
Like, sequencer doing a drum beat, and they walk back and kind of segues into Sympathy for the Devil.
How Sympathy for the Devil go? Please believe me!
The Honky Tonk Woman.
She's a ho!
Here comes Keith Richards.
Okay, we're going to bring up my main man, Keith.
Slipping Away and Before They Make Me Run.
What's Slipping Away? Before They Make Me Run, that's a good one. Before They Make Me Run off Some Girls, my favorite Stones album, Some Girls. That and Goat's Head Soup.
Miss You with...
I've been hauling us along. The Plunkets band I play on with Mick Cripps and Patrico and Charlie and Kent and Billy, we play Miss You.
A bass solo
I've been hauling off. Oh, okay, you get it.
The very funky Daryl Jones.
Yeah. I miss Bill
probably
Wyman.
Probably a better bassist than Bill Wyman.
Bill Wyman, way underrated on bass. That guy laid it down, man. Laid it down. He's one of my favorite bass players, actually. Way underrated.
Go crazy in that song.
Hello?
All right. Painted Black.
I see a red door and I want to paint it black.
Midnight Rambler.
You heard about the Boston.
Start me up.
Start me up. On Some Girls.
Ben Jack.
Is that on Some Girls or is that on, could be on Tattoo You. Jumping Jack Flash. He's a kid. Plunkett's also play that.
Then the encore.
Oh, good night.
Sugar.
Brown Sugar.
Give Me Shelter.
Featherwitch plays that.
I Can't Get No Satisfaction.
I Can't Get Me No.
So, the video screens were really good. I was in the top.
Chucky posted a bunch of pictures. Row. And Chris Capel also sent me pictures from one of the nights.
We were.
I think he sent me two
times. Great video screens. We were right in front, so it was. The sound was really, really
way to impress the girl with front row seats or close up.
Some better than most stadium shows. The only problem with the sound was just on like the high end, like the harmonica or some of the guitar leads, it could be a little louder, but everything was really clear. And besides the Four Stones and Daryl Jones, they have the guy from the Allman Brothers, Chuck Lavelle, on keyboards.
Oh, yeah, that's right. He's been with them.
They had a horn section. Bobby Keys, unfortunately, had passed away a few years ago. So they had this other funky guy playing saxophone and two backup singers. And it wasn't Lisa Fisher, who's been doing it the last few years.
Wow, good knowledge.
It was a different woman who was really good. They were very energetic. It was kind of an emotional show because...
Really?
You know, everybody knew about the problems Mick Jagger had and with his heart operation. So that's that. I actually did write a little thing about it at my blog, albumsatimeforgot.com.
You
guys can all check that out.
Albumsatimeforgot.com.
Three emotional concerts I've been to, a Cheap Trick and a Rush one. But you guys can all look at that. And then on the 5th, I went to this... Same place again, this time with two of my siblings, so obviously it was not as fun as
now.
Date.
How did the date go? How did the date end up, Chris Capel? Are you gonna let us know? Is that on this comment, or hope it went well?
Who we had an awesome time with. Did I mention I had an awesome time with the date and I really like her? All right,
well, I hope she calls you back, friend. She calls you back. You know how it is when you really like them. Got to play hard to get. Got to play it cool, man.
The set list. Everything else.
But Chris Capel's got a great... He's a great guy. He's got a great personality. And he might be a little too rock geeked out. Sometimes the rock geek scares the chicks away. But if she's a super rock geek, you might impress her with your knowledge. But hey, man, if it scares her away... she wasn't for you to begin with.
Same. So here we go. Jumpin' Jack Flash. You Got Me Rocking.
Oh, they started.
Tumbling Dice. Uh-huh. Here we go.
So they changed the first two.
Shuffle. That's an oddball one.
Yeah.
And then for the one fans voted on, Monkey Man.
Ooh, I'm a monkey!
You Can't Always Get What You Want. Uh-huh. Off to the... B stage, Let It Bleed,
Oh, that's a good one, man. We all need someone we can cream on. All right, I'm going to shut up.
Powers, Sympathy for the Devil, Honky Tonk Woman.
Honky Tonk.
You Got the Silver, Before They Make
You
Run.
Silver?
Miss You.
Also, they did a different Keith song. Okay.
Rambler, Paint It Black, Start Me Up, Brown Sugar, Give Me Shelter, I Can't Get No Satisfaction. So out of the 19 songs, they played 15 the same.
So there's sections of the show where they switch them up. Yeah, that's what Cheap Trick does, too.
Both nights. I was hoping it would be, you know, they'd play 5 of the same songs and 14 different.
No,
but
no, that's what Aerosmith does, what Cheap Trick does. They change up maybe 5 songs, you know, or if that, but yeah. But, you know, it's better than not changing them up at all, like some bands do. Judas Priest, Iron Maiden, all them.
Can't always get what you want. So, there you go. There's my show review. I know it's been a while since I've given one.
Yes.
I'm glad I'm the first one in with a Stones show review on this No Filter tour, which isn't really hitting a lot of cities. It's really kind of short. But That's the 14th and 15th time I've seen the Rolling Stones.
I don't
since
think
1981
I have. I don't think
tech.
I've ever seen the Stones live.
U tour, and I haven't seen them since 2006 because they haven't played a lot of shows in the Northeast. They just haven't. And the next show I'm going to, I think, unless I go to Zebra, will be the ZZ Top 50th anniversary.
Yeah, you take the chick to ZZ Top. I doubt she would like Zebra, but hey, you never know, she might.
Trick show. It's in a month.
Wait a minute. Oh, yeah, ZZ Top and Cheap Trick.
I think, unless I go to Zebra, will be the ZZ Top 50th anniversary with Cheap Trick show. It's in a month from now. It's the 19th down in Jones Beach in Long Island. And if nobody else gives a show review of that, I will.
Thank you.
But that's the story, and I'm sticking with it.
Exactly.
Chris Capel, rock and roll copywriter, signing off.
All right. You too can leave a show review, especially for the dog days of podcasting. Area code 706-621-ROCK, or do like Chris Capel did, the preferred way. Just email it to me, rockandrollgeek@gmail.com. All right. So I spun the iTunes wheel. This song came up, which coincidentally, Mike LaPlante posted something on the Rock and Roll Geek Facebook group, which I did not create, but I do approve people. Just have to answer two questions, so I know you're not a Alex Jones, conspiracy theorist, domestic terrorist. Before I'll read what he posted. Happy birthday, Phil Lynott. The great Phil Lynott. I call him Phil Lynott, but I think it's pronounced Lynott. Also, happy birthday to Robert Plant and Mike LaPlante. Pardon me, I'm burping this fine Modelo, which, by the way, is my first one of the day. And after a long day of work, that's good. Modelo, best one of the day, even. Mike LaPlante said, today is tragically hip day. Every year on August 20th, I celebrate tragically hip day. It's not Gord Downie's birthday or the day he passed away. It's the day that we as a country came together to celebrate a true national treasure, something we call our own and to be proud of, the boys from Kingston, Ontario. If you're reading this and have a drink nearby, be sure to give a toast to the man and the band that made a nation come together one summer night in 2016 and gave us some awesome tunes to listen to for many more nights to come. All right, well, thank you for that, Mike LaPlante. And so I spun the iTunes wheel, and I swear to God, this is true. The song that came up was a song by the Tragically Hip called Fireworks, and that's what I'm going to play, friends. I will not lie to you. I'm not a huge Tragically Hip fan. I don't even know hardly anything about it. I mean, I don't have anything against them, but I'm not a huge fan. I mean, I don't know much about them. I don't dislike them. They're okay. Don't kill me, Canada, but they're fine. But I do have Tragically Hip on my iTunes, and I don't dislike them, so I like them just fine. Mike LaPlante, don't kill me, but they came up on the iTunes wheel. And for you, Mike LaPlante, this song, Fireworks. Thank you for listening, friends. Please keep the donations coming. By the way, I've not done one long show this month yet, which means I don't charge the Patreon people for any shows yet until I do a long one. So have not made any money this month except for the PayPal donors, which thank you so much, friends. So this is going to be a lean month, even though I've been doing something every day on the Rock and Roll Geek Show. Lean month. Did you get any value for these daily shows? If you did, this show is a value for value. So whatever you think you got, value you got, I ask that you please, as Adam Curry says, chip in. All right. Here's Fireworks from the Tragically Hip. I'll talk to you tomorrow. Oh, by the way, in less than 2 hours, I will be doing a Mad at Dad show with my podcast mentor, Dave Slusher. So hope to see you over there in the chat room, mattatdadpodcast.com/live. Here's the Tragically Hip. I'll talk to you tomorrow, friends.
If there's a goal that everyone remembers, it was back in '72. We all squeezed the stick and we all pulled the trigger, and all I remember is sitting beside you. You said you didn't give a fuck about hockey, and I never saw someone say that before. You held my hand and we walked home the long way. You were loosening my grip on Bobby.
It's a rock and roll geek train wreck.